Good morning, children. Good morning, Makra. How are you all? You all are fine? Okay. So, in the last class, we were learning the lesson, an unusual birthday gift. It was a letter written by our first Prime Minister, Mr. Jawaharlal Nehru, to his daughter, Priyadarshini Indira Gandhi. Whom did he write the letter? Priyadarshini Indira Gandhi. Okay, in that letter, he was writing about a visitor, Hyun Stank. He was a visitor, came from China, and he wrote a book about our country and the wealth and the glory of our country. And then in that book, he mentioned about a person from a Bihar who was wearing unusual clothes. Unusual clothes means he was tying the copper plates on his stomach and some other items which we use in the kitchen around his body. He was thinking that my stomach may get burst and these copper plates will hold it. They will hold it. And then he was saying that person was saying, I love myself because I talk on unusual things, but whatever I talk, they will be very important things. And then he used to think about himself, he's a wise man. And then he would think that I can advise the people who can listen to me, who can understand what I speak. And then what he said, I have liked my talks with you and we have discussed many things, but the world is wide and beyond our world lie other wonderful and mysterious world. What was he thinking? That I have discussed many things with you. This world is very wide and beyond the wide world there is a mysterious world, means unsolved things. There are many unsolved things. And then, just a minute, children. Need ever be bold or imagine like the very foolish and consistent person whose story Hyun Stank. He was written this story about that person. That is, he is very different person. He is a different person who was wearing different type of clothes. And then what else he says? He says that do you remember how fascinated you were when you first read the story Jane the Arc, and how your ambition was to be something like her. Then Mr. Jawaharlal Nehru reminds the Indira Gandhi that when she read the story of Jane for the first time and how she was fascinated about her dreams. She wanted to achieve something in her life. So he tells her, you have to follow your dreams. If you want to achieve something in the world, you have to follow your dreams. Don't think about the people and about the world or about the society. Be passionate. In this world is full of people who think only about their bread and butter and their day's survival. The people who want to do something in their life, they think beyond that. So I want you to be a different person in this world, not a regular person who thinks only about his family and their bread and butter. You are different than others. So this letter is like one-sided speech, but don't take it as one-sided. You think that we both are sitting in front of each other and we are discussing about these matters. Often we may be in doubt as to what to do. It is not so easy matter to decide what is right and what is not. Often we may be in doubt. Sometimes what happens, we will be in the doubt. Is it right or is it wrong? Is it correct or is it wrong? Am I doing correct thing? Am I doing wrong? What people will think? What should I answer? Whether I will be answerable, whether they will be question me, these doubts will come in our mind when we will be playing, when we will be doing something, before doing something, before taking some decisions. These all doubts will come into our mind. One little test I shall ask you to apply whenever you are in doubt. One thing he want to apply her whenever she is in doubt. It may help you. And he thinks, Jawaharlal Nehru thinks that it may help her. Never do anything in secret or anything that you would wish to hide. Don't do anything in secret. Do it in openly. Don't hide it from anyone. Whatever you are doing, do it openly. Do it. Don't hide it. For the desire to hide anything means that you are afraid. When you think that I have to hide it, then it means you are getting scared. You are scared about it. Afraid means scared. Scared andre hedrodu. And fear is a bad thing and unworthy of you. Be brave and all the rest follows. When you think, when you get scared, when you get fear, it is bad thing. It is bad thing. When you get scared of doing something, it is bad. When you try to hide something, it is bad. It is unworthy. It is not worth. It is not worth. It is unworthy. Unworthy means it is useless. When you hide things from people, it becomes unworthy. So you have to be brave and all the rest will follow. When you are doing something, learn to be brave. Do it with a bravely and other things will follow you. If you are brave, you will not fear and you will not do anything of which you are ashamed. When you are brave, when you are sure that I am doing correct, then you will never feel scared and you will never feel ashamed that I may doing wrong. You never try to hide from the people. You will face them openly. And then you know that in our great freedom movement, under Bapuji's leadership, there is no room for secrecy or hiding. And then he reminds her, when we are into the great freedom movement, in under the leadership of Bapuji, under the leadership of Bapuji, and we are not doing anything secretly. We are not hiding anything. We are doing it openly. We are telling it to the world that we are going to do this and we are following this. So you also have to learn. I want you also to learn this. We have nothing to hide. We are not afraid of what we do and what we say. We have nothing to hide. We want our freedom. We are fighting for it. So we are not doing anything secretly. We are saying it openly to the world and we are doing it. We work in the sun and in the light. We never do it in the dark. We never do it in the dark. Means we are not hiding it with anyone. We are doing it openly in the dark, in the open day, in the light. Even so, in our private lives, let us make friends with the sun and work in light and do nothing secretly for furtively. Or privacy, of course, we may have and should have, but that is very different thing. That is very different thing from secrecy. Even in our personal life, whatever we are doing, whatever you are making friendship with any person, do it openly. Don't keep it any secret, or don't try to make it privacy. Privacy means it is mine. I have to do it inside the four walls. Don't think that. Do it openly. Say it to the world. Say aloud. So you will be brave. You will be appreciated by the people. You will face the people bravely. So whenever you are doing the things, do it under the sun. Do it in the open. Don't try to hide it. Take the decision and face the people. Don't try to make it private प्राइवेटली और सीक्रेटली. इट इज़ द रूल दैट आई वॉन्ट टू फॉलो यू इन द लाइफ. दिस वॉज द ग्रेट लेसन थॉट बाय जवाहरलाल नेहरू टू हिज डॉटर इंदिरा प्रियदर्शिनी इंदिरा गांधी. प्रियदर्शिनी इंदिरा आफ्टर मैरिज शी टर्न्ड इनटू द गांधी. सो देन शी फॉलोड दिस लाइन्स ऑफ हर फादर एंड शी स्टार्ट शी बिकेम अ फेमस लीडर ऑफ अवर कंट्री. सो चिल्ड्रन वेन एवर यू आर डूइंग समथिंग इफ यू थिंक दैट इट इज़ रॉन्ग इफ आई डू इट आई मे हैव टू आंसर फॉर द पेरेंट्स. नाउ एट दिस एज वेन यू आर डूइंग समथिंग टेल इट टू योर पेरेंट्स openly, I want to do this and don't keep any secret, don't make it private, tell it and do it. Then they will also appreciate, they will also help you. So there should not be any hide and seek between you and your parents. Or whenever, when you grow up, when you go for the job, there also you should follow this rule. When you do it openly, everyone will appreciate. If it is wrong, they will tell you. You learn to accept. First thing we have to learn in our life is accept. Whatever feedback we get it, we must learn to accept it. So children, read the lesson, try to understand, discuss with your parents. Okay, take care. We meet in the next class.